Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the third chapter of Moments, Iswaran the Storyteller by R.K. Lakshman. In this chapter, we will see how a person who is all in one for his master, means a cook, an entertainer, and everything for his master. When he makes up his story, it's like an entertaining sort for his master. But how these type of stories creates a problem for his master. Let's start Iswaran the Storyteller. The story was narrated by Ganesh, by a young man. Mahendra by name, means Mahendra narrates this story to Ganesh. He was a junior supervisor in a firm which offered on hire supervisors at various types of construction sites like factories, bridges, dams, and so on. Mahendra was a junior supervisor working in a firm whose work was to hire supervisors for looking after construction sites of dams, bridges, and so on. Mahendra's job was to keep an eye on the activities at the work site. He had to keep moving from place to place every now and then as ordered by his head office. From a coal mining area to a railway bridge construction site. From there, after a few months, to a chemical plant which was coming up somewhere. Means, over here we can see Mahendra's job is a job which doesn't allow a person to stay in a place. So, today, if he is over here in a mining field, tomorrow he might have to go for some other site to look after. He was a bachelor. His needs were simple and he was able to adjust himself to all kinds of odd situations. Mahendra was a bachelor person and his requirements were very little and he was able to adjust according to the situation where he was staying, like whether it was an ill-equipped circuit house or a makeshift canvas tent in the middle of a stone quarry. That means wherever he has to live, he adjusts himself according to the situation. But one asset he had was his cook Iswaran. And the biggest asset which Mahendra had was his cook, whose name was Iswaran. The cook was quite attached to Mahendra and followed him uncomplainingly wherever he was posted. Means the cook was closely attached to Mahendra. Wherever Mahendra went, the cook also followed him. He cooked for Mahendra, washed his clothes, and chatted away with his master at night. His duties involved cooking, washing, and entertaining by his gossips to his master. He'd weave out endless stories and anecdotes on varied subjects. Means he was a good storyteller, and he was a sort of person who shows himself that he knows each and every topic and can speak on every topic. Iswaran also had an amazing capacity to produce vegetables and cooking ingredients seemingly out of nowhere in the middle of a desolate landscape with no shops visible for miles around. Easwaran had a good capacity of growing vegetables, where no shops were seen for miles and miles. He would miraculously conjure up the most delicious dishes made with fresh vegetables within an hour of arriving at the zinc seed shelter at the new workplace. Means, away we can see that Easwaran was a good cook. He cooks very delicious food for his master Mahendra. Mahendra would be up early in the morning and leave for work after breakfast, carrying some prepared food with him. The daily routine of Mahendra was getting up early in the morning, taking his breakfast and his lunch to his office. Meanwhile, Easwaran would tidy up the shed, wash the clothes and have a leisurely bath, pouring several buckets of water over his head, muttering a prayer all the while. After Mahendra left for his office, Easwaran would tidy up the shed, living area, wash the clothes and took a good deep water bath. While he took the bath, he used to mutter some prayer. It would be lunchtime by then. After eating, he would read for a while before dozing off. Means, after taking his bath and completing all sort of works, it would be lunchtime. He would take his lunch and before dozing, means taking a nap, he would read a book. The book was usually some popular Tamil thriller running of hundreds of pages. The book which he used to read were Tamil thrillers. Its imaginative descriptions and narrative phrases would hold Easwaran in a thrill. Means, when he used to read that type of stories, the stories would attach Easwaran. Easwaran was totally attached with the Tamil stories which he used to read. His own description was greatly influenced by the Tamil authors that he read. When he was narrating even the smallest incidents, he would try to work in suspense and a surprise ending into account. When Easwaran used to narrate some story or incident to his master Mahendra, he would try to take up some incident from the book, Tamil thriller book, which he used to read. For example, instead of saying that he had come across an uprooted tree on the highway, he would say, with eyebrows suitably arched and hands held out in a dramatic gesture, "The road was deserted and I was all alone." Instead of saying that he had seen an uprooted tree, he used to say, "The road was desolate and he was the only person on the road. Suddenly I spotted something that looked like an enormous bushy beast lying sprawled across the road." Again, he would explain it that he saw a bushy beast which was lying in the middle of the road. "I was half inclined to turn and go back, but as I came closer, I saw that it was a fallen tree and its dry branches spread out." He used to say that while he was turning to go back, he came closer to that so-called bushy beast and he recognized that it was a dry, uprooted tree. Mahendra would stretch himself back in his canvas chair and listen to Easwaran's tales uncritically. Mahendra was also interested in the tales which were said by Easwaran. "The place I come from is famous for timber." Timber means wood. Easwaran would begin. Easwaran again began that from place where he hailed, belonged, was a timber land. "There is a richly wooded forest all around. The logs were hauled on the troll lorries by elephants. There are huge well-fed beasts, means elephants were used for hauling up, what to say, logs on the trees. When they turn wild, even the most experienced mouth is not able to control them. He also says that when the elephant turns wild, experienced mouth is also not able to control that animal. After this prolonged, Iswaran would launch into an elaborate anecdote involving an elephant. After this, Iswaran was totally involved in a big story which involved an elephant. Means now Iswaran was going to start a story which totally involved an story of an elephant. So let's stop till here. We'll proceed further in the next video. Thank you.